Hi guys, and welcome to my channel. For this upcoming Thanksgiving, I want to share some recipes, and I'm sure a lot of us are not having big traditional dinner. But before I do that, I want to be thankful for what I have. I'm thankful for nights that turned into mornings, friends that turned into family, and dreams that turned into reality. A year 2020 was kind of a roller coaster, so I am having a very small dinner at my house. But I wanted to be fancy, and this is what I come up with, and I'm gonna call it fancy mashed potatoes. So let's see what we need for this wonderful dish. And here is the list of the ingredients for your screenshots, and also will be listed in the description box below. Let's get started. I have about 5 pounds of baking potatoes, and those are the kinds that easier to mash without any lumps. I also have 8 ounces of cream cheese, 2 egg yolks. I have about 8 tablespoons of butter. I have some salt and pepper to taste, and I'm using white pepper, and I have a cup of Romano cheese, which is grated, and for decoration we're gonna use chives. I was asked so many times what is the easiest way to peel a potato, and by all means you can use a vegetable peeler, and I know some people are really good at it. I'm not, but I am good at peeling potatoes with my paring knife. So I just go around and take the skin off, just like that. Then if you have a potatoes as large as these, you can quarter them and just place them in the pot. This way they will just cook faster, and I have about 6-quart pot here. As I told you, I'm not making loads of potatoes this year. We're just gonna cover it with water and place it on the stove to boil. As soon as the water starts to boil, I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of salt, and this is optional, but I like to add 1 bay leaf to my potatoes. It's just gonna give them a very nice flavor. Then we're gonna close the lid, and we're gonna boil our potatoes until they're fork or knife tender, which will take you about 25 to 30 minutes. Then we're gonna remove our bay leaf, and we're ready to mash them. So get your favorite potato masher out and start mashing these potatoes. And as you can see, there's absolutely no effort to mash those to a very, very silky consistency. Then we're gonna add our butter, and work in your butter into the potatoes. And as you can see, as soon as the butter hits the potatoes, it melts, and the potatoes become much creamier. Then we're gonna add the cream cheese. If you noticed, I'm not using any milk or cream in my potatoes because I'm gonna mold them a certain way, so I want them to hold on to their shape, and that's why I am using cream cheese instead of either cream or milk. Then we're gonna add our salt and white pepper. And after that, we're gonna add Romano cheese. Why Romano cheese? Romano cheese melts much more evenly, and this will give your potatoes sort of like a souffle texture. And for your potatoes to really hold on to their shape, we're gonna add 2 egg yolks. And those have to be added at the end, because if you add them in the beginning, they simply will curdle. Then spray your baking dish with non-stick cooking spray, and I have the oval one because, you know, as I told you, I'm going fancy all the way. And then I'm gonna transfer my potatoes into the piping bag, and I have a really large one. You don't have to do it, you could just simply spread your potatoes into the baking dish, make some patterns with your spatula, and bake them this way. But I want them my potatoes to look like little rosettes. And to give them a little height, you just need to squeeze your potatoes to give them height, and then go around. And as you can see, it looks like rosettes. And when they baked, it would be easier to portion them out on the plate because you simply could just detach one rosette from your baking dish and put it on somebody's plate. And look how pretty they look. They look like roses. The amount of ingredients I use for this dish can simply feed 6 people or 6 big people and maybe some kids. And that's why I'm making a little leftover potatoes I'm gonna put in a smaller baking dish, and those are gonna be baked for the kids' table. How cool is that? Bake your fancy potatoes at 385 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 minutes or until they're slightly golden brown. You can decorate your fancy potatoes with something fancy, which is chives. So I'm gonna chop some chives and I'm gonna sprinkle them at the end. And here you are, 35 minutes later, your potatoes should look as pretty as these, or as these. Then simply sprinkle some chopped chives, or not. If you wish, you can use parsley. Let them cool just a little bit, and then, as you can see, they come out as easy as that. If I can describe the texture of these potatoes, it would be, or wow, it tastes like a potato souffle. And here you go, portion control. You can just get this little rosette on your plate and don't overeat your mashed potatoes. I hope you like this video. Blessings to you, your family, and your friends. Stick together, guys. This awful year is almost over. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you soon. Bye!